same yesterday and forever or tomorrow, past tense, present tense, and future tense.
Yeah.
Even from the days of your father, you have gone away from mine ordinance. He tracked it all the way back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Moses. He said, return unto me, and I will return unto you. Will a man rob God? That's a good subject right there.
Yeah.
Yet you have robbed me, but you say, wherein have we done it? In tithes and offering. You are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. And so, as we look to put this homiletical construct together today, we'll look at our PowerPoints under Don't Block Your Blessings. PowerPoint number one, Israel's blessings were being blocked because they failed to put first things first.
Yeah.
Now, we have to learn to put first things first. Look what they did to disrespect God in Malachi 1, 6 through 9. And if you would turn there and get the understanding, Malachi 1, 6 through 9, he said, a son honoreth his father and a servant his master. If then I be a father, where is my honor or respect? And if I be a master, where is my fear, saith the Lord? In other words, my reverence. Of hosts unto you, O priest, that despise my name. And you say, wherein have we despised thy name? You have polluted bread upon mine altar. And you say, wherein have we polluted thee? In that you say, the table of the Lord is contemptible. And if you offer the blind for sacrifice, is it not evil? And if you offer the lame and sick, is it not evil? Offer it now unto thy governor. Will he be pleased with thee, or accept thy person, said the Lord of hosts? And now I beg you, beseech God that he will be gracious unto us. This has been by your means. Will he regard your persons, said the Lord of hosts? So what were they doing? They were bringing these animals for sacrifice that they wouldn't even give to the governor. But they were bringing them in the presence of God. They had no reverence for God, no respect for God. They had cut off the blessings that God had given them. They showed no respect to God for what he was doing for them. Listen, church, we must put God first. You see, in a word, they were shooting themselves down, shooting themselves in the foot. You might as well just say, shooting themselves down. Somebody said, what do you mean, shooting themselves in the foot? Well, the blessings that would normally be theirs, they were blocking because they had blocked their giving from God, and therefore it was a residual effect.
Yeah.
That the blessings were cut off that would come from God to them.
Yeah.
Say amen if you can.
Amen.
Somebody said, well, could you enlighten us a bit that we might see? Sometimes you think that you, but the joke was on them.
Yeah.
Somebody said, well, how could that be? The late brother Kenny K. Mitchell used to tell about how that K.K. Mitchell told about some men that went to a mental asylum. And they were there, and as they were at the mental asylum, they looked outside of the mental institution, and they saw a man out there with his pole and hook, and he was fishing in a bar. And there he was fishing. And several of the men huddled up there together. One said, let's go have some fun with this fellow.
Yeah.
Out there fishing in the garden over here with his fishing hook. And so one went up to him and said, how many have you caught? And he said, well, I hadn't caught anything until you came up. Said to you were the first foolish man that I caught today. And he said, well, what are you talking about? He said, well, who else But a person that was unsane or insane that would ask, how many fish had I caught from this garden? You know nobody caught any fish from this garden. Say amen if you can. Don't you see sometimes we can shoot ourselves in the foot? And so, as I move on here, first things first, turn to Matthew 5, verse number 20, which is a rather familiar passage. And Jesus, in the heart of his Sermon on the Mount, said over there, he says, seek ye and accept your righteousness. Exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will in no wise enter into the kingdom of heaven. Now, a lot of times we have abused this passage, in my judgment. Somebody said, what do you mean? We say, well, we gotta make sure that we exceed or go beyond what they did in Moses. Well, I say to you, you gotta be careful with that. Because once you calculate the tithes that they had to give unto Moses, it would calculate at least 30%. So you gotta be careful. But he's talking about a righteousness under the law of Moses was a self-imposed righteousness. It was a self-made righteousness. And that's what God wanted them to surpass or get past, that kind of righteousness. He said, except your righteousness exceeds or goes beyond that of the scribes and Pharisees, which would be under the Mosaic law. He said, you will in no wise enter into the kingdom of God. Somebody said, well, what kind of righteousness does God want us to have? I'm glad you asked that question. Back to the Bible I go. I'm looking over here now in Romans chapter 10, where the Bible talks about God's program. Whereas the Jews were still trying to push their program and stay under Moses' law. Paul said, oh, they're brethren, my heart desire and proud of God for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. For they be ignorant of God's righteousness, and are not about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. For Christ is the end of the law unto righteousness unto everyone that believeth. Say amen if you can. So they were trying to go right then and get the Moses law, which was built upon their own program. But God has a righteousness now. And somebody says, is it built on meritorious deeds? In other words, can we lift ourselves by our own bootstraps? No, no, no. The only way we can be saved is through the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Yes. Somebody said, well, where is that in the Bible? Back to the Bible, I go. In 2 Corinthians 5:21, the Bible says over there, for he has made him, Jesus, to be sin for us. When did he make him to be sin? That was talking about the sin sacrifice that he paid at Mount Calvary. Who knew no sin, and that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. So the only righteousness we have is the righteousness of God in Christ. Say amen if you can. So the Bible is right. No wonder when you look at our own selves, Paul cried out in the Galatians 2:20. He said, I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. The life that I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and who gave himself for me. Say amen. So we got to get ourselves if we're going to make it. Look at Israel, ancient Israel, coming up disrespecting God. I'm here to tell you that you'll shoot yourselves in the foot every time, because God is going to get his one way or the other. Say amen if you can. Oh yes, he'll get his. But let me move on. Number two, PowerPoint number two. God made his requirements about tithing clear under the law of Moses. Let us do some research as we look at Leviticus chapter 27. Let's get in the Bible now, church. Leviticus chapter 27, verse number 30 through 34. And I'll give you time to get page there in Leviticus 27, verse 30 through 34. Now, although this was under the Mosaic law, we can study about an attitude. Now, the Bible shows in verse 30, and all the tithe of the land, whether of the seed of the land or the fruit of the trees, is the Lord's. It is holy unto the Lord. So the Lord wanted from all of the tithes, which shows that he had more than one tithe. Say amen. Amen. And each tithe was 10%. So we have to bear that in mind. And then he said, if a man shall at all redeem all of the tithes, he shall add thereto the fifth part thereof. And concerning the tithe of the herd and of the flock, even of whatsoever passes under the rod, the tenth shall be holy unto the Lord. He said, he shall not search whether it be good or bad, neither shall he charge change it. And if he change it at all, then both it and the change thereof shall be holy, it shall not be redeemed. These are the commandments which the Lord commanded Moses for the children of Israel in Mount Sinai. So everything, the crops, the animals, the fruit, God wanted the first fruit. Say amen. Amen. Everything for his part. And then, not only that, but we look over here in Deuteronomy 14, verses 22 to 23. Now in Deuteronomy chapter 14, verse number 22 and 23, we have some more directions about the tithing system. The Bible says, thou shalt truly tithe all the increase of thy seed that the field bringeth forth year by year. And thou shalt eat before the Lord thy God in the place which he shall choose, the place is named there. The tithe of thy corn, of thy wine, of thy oil, the firstlings of thy herds, of thy flocks, that thou mayest learn to fear the Lord thy God always. And if the way be too long for thee, so that thou art not able to carry it, or if the place be too far from thee, that is your house, from the designated place where God put his name, which the Lord thy God shall choose to set his name there, when the Lord thy God hath blessed thee, then shalt thou turn it unto money, and bind up the money in thine hand, and shall go into the place which the Lord thy God shall choose. In other words, if you live at a greater distance where you can't, it's impossible, if impractical, for you to get to the holy, to the place where he put his name. Then God says, then translate all that over from the livestock and the fruit and so on into money. And send the money, because God would have to have his part. Can you all see it? Amen. All right, now somebody say, wait a minute. How many times did God require? Well, in Deuteronomy 16, verses 16 through 17, I want you to travel with me there in the 16th chapter of the book of Deuteronomy and the 16th verse. The Bible says, three times in a year shall all the male. And that shows that God wanted the men to lead out. Say amen. Amen. And he still wants the male to lead out. Say amen. Well, amen. God wants the men to lead. And he says, shall appear before the Lord thy God in the place which he shall choose. In the feast of unleavened bread, that would be that of the Passover. And the feast of weeks, that would be that of Pentecost. And in the feast of tabernacles, and they shall appear before the Lord. They shall not appear before the Lord empty. Every man shall give as his aim, according to the blessings of the Lord thy God, which he had given thee. Yes. Three times a year, they had to make the trip to Jerusalem. Yes. Say amen. Yes. To give according to what God had specified. According to the tithing system that was under the Mosaic law. And so the Bible is right. Now, somebody says, well, Brother Foster, you're going through that now. And, but what about us? Well, hold the phone. I want you to know that we are not under the tithing system. But I would be afraid to go below that was required, don't you see? Somebody said, well, what are you basing that on? I'm basing it on the fact that we